The biggest motorsport spectacle in the world is all set to come to India. And in just a few weeks' time, the Budh International Circuit in Greater Noida will be ground zero for, yes, you guessed it right, Formula One. Well, I'm going to bring you a special F1 update right here every day in Pit Report. Now, I know a lot of you already know about F1, but for those who don't, let's start right at the beginning as to how this multi-billion dollar industry that it actually has become today came into existence. It's very different from what it was initially. Manufacturers used to use it as a testbed for their future road cars. Formula A, as it was first known, began in 1946 when the FIA standardized the rules for single-seater racing. It had its roots in the European Grand Prix motor racing and came to be known as Formula One. The inaugural championship race was held in 1950 at Silverstone Circuit. The legendary American race, the Indy 500, was also a part of the F1 championship, despite not adhering to F1 technical regulations. The history of the sport is largely parallel to its technical regulations. And the F1 season today consists of a series of races known as Grand Prix, held on special circuits and even public roads in the form of street races. Factual history aside, the credit of making this competition into a multi-million dollar business and the largest watched annual sport event goes to this man, Bernie Eccleston. Bernie, as the world knows him, began with managing teams in the 50s, but it was his purchase of the Brabham team in 1971 that gained him a seat on the F1 Constructors Association. In 1978, Bernie became the president of the association and completely changed the way Formula One's commercial rights were managed. In the early years, Formula One teams were factory-owned, and it was the circuit owners who largely controlled the financial aspects. Bernie turned it all around on its head and started offering Formula One as a sort of sales package to circuit owners. They had to completely surrender trackside advertising, and big money started flowing into the Formula One business. Large corporate sponsors began spending millions to have their names and logos on the cars and alongside the racetrack. And this is how Formula One became the glitz, glamour and glorious sport that we know today. Bernie Eccleston has built his reputation as a great administrator, manager and innovator in the world of Formula One. Well, he's the one responsible for taking the sport into many new countries and building it into the global phenomenon that it actually is today. This in turn has roped in new sponsors, new drivers and new teams. We'll be talking about these teams tomorrow because for now, it's a wrap from Pit Report.
America's the strength.